Nalla Narasimha Reddy, Education Societies Group of Institutions, Integrated Campus. This is Dr. G. Subbarao. In today's session, I am going to speak about diets, cells, batteries in petrology as a part of engineering geology. Let us continue the topic. Dikes, silts, batteries. Igneous intrusions form when magma cools and solidifies before it reaches the surface. What are igneous intrusions? Igneous intrusions are silts, dikes, batteries, Lopolis, Lapolis, etc. And the important igneous intrusions are going to discuss here silts, dikes, and batteries. So these intrusions are formed when magma cools and solidifies before it reaching the surface. Igneous intrusions of dikes, silts, batholiths occur in various sizes and various forms, that means various shapes, depending upon the conditions during the time of formation. The intrusion which cut across the host rock is called as dike. See the picture very clearly. These are the geological formations, host rock, in which the igneous intrusion is cutting across. This is called dike. Field loop photograph clearly showing how a dike is cutting across the host rock. Dike is the common form in igneous rocks, and these dikes occur as vertical or inclined. That means the dike may be vertical or inclined. So dikes occur cutting across the bedding planes of the country rocks in which they are formed. Due to pressure, of course, which is very forceful in nature, so the magma intrudes through the fractures or cracks or joints or weak planes, whatever present in the host rock, and subsequently solidification takes place and finally it gives rise to dikes. The dimensions of dikes vary from region, place to place. For example, the dikes may be long as 50 to 60 kilometers and a thickness up to 30 meters. We can see good example, Scotland Midland Valley of Dike. Sometimes the dikes may be very short, that means up to a few meters in length and a few centimeters of thin. We can see the Midland Valley of Scotland dike here. It's the world's biggest dike body. Dikes are important from civil engineering point of view. They are in fact undesirable at the sites of foundations of dams or reservoirs as their sites turn out to be weak planes. Dikes are important because they are very hard, durable, black in color, fine grained, and some of the dike rocks are used in making of statues and sculptures. This is the sculpture of Indian god Pageshwari, and this sculpture is made from the basalt rock from 5th century. Sometimes the dike body gives rise to springs. Coming to another igneous intrusion is sill. See the sill, which is occupied parallel to the bedding planes. This is the field photograph where the sill is occupied parallel to the bedding planes, very clearly seen. Sill is the igneous intrusion which is parallel to the layering in the host rock. Can see very clearly the sill, how it is occupied. Another field photograph, how the sill is occupied parallel to the bedding planes of the host rock. Sills which is spread in over large areas and are generally thin with uniform thickness. All these igneous intrusions, that means sills, occur as horizontal bodies. The great Wynn Sill of England spreads over 3,900 square kilometers. This is Great Wynn Sill of England. And another important sill, that is Carew Sill, with a dolerite composition, which spreads over 5,10,000 square kilometers in South Africa. A very big sill. The spreading capacity of a sill usually depends on the viscosity of magma, its temperature, and weight of the overburden, that means overlying rocks. So all these parameters influence the spreading capacity of a spill in the area. That is the reason sills vary from place to place, reason to reason. Sills sometimes act as a mineralizing bodies. Some of the important mineralizing bodies of varieties, asbestos, can be noticed in Andhra Pradesh, Kadapa Basin, where the varieties and asbestos deposits are associated with the sills. Another igneous intrusion called as batholiths. These are the pictures of batholith. What is a batholith? Batholith is a large body of igneous rock intrusion, usually formed beneath the surface under solidification of magma. Batholith usually composed of coarse granular rocks having a composition of granite or granodiorite composition with a surface exposure of 100 square kilometers or even more than that. Batholiths usually can be seen in mountain regions and are parallel to the folded regions. As mentioned earlier, batholiths are either granite in composition or granodiorite in composition. This is one huge batholith, British Columbia batholith of 1250 miles extension and a width of 50 miles. Recent studies have shown that many of the batholiths have a thickness of 10 to 15 kilometers. This is a well-known batholith located in the Sierra Nevada range of California, US, with more thickness. A variety of silts oftenly contain important ore deposits. The Bushveld, Incisiva, and the Great Dyke Complex of South Africa, the Duluth Intrusive Complex, Still Water Igneous Complex of US, Rum Peridotite Complex of Scotland, the Skagerrak Igneous Complex of Greenland. So, we can find a variety of dikes and sills in all these areas. And these dikes and sills often contain concentrations of gold, platinum, chromium, and other rare earth elements. Thank you.